The wine cellar shop is stacked full. Owner and importer Bonaventure Isaiah got his consignment of exotic wines days back and is setting up for a fresh round of sales. But this business and many others like it may suffer a major setback as the government has recently approved a tariff hike on tobacco products and alcohol beverages.
The government, you know, they don't like, you know, this type of, you know, importation. They want it, you know, to be produced, you know, here. So, and definitely the increment in tariff, you know, is affecting, you know, the business. It's affecting the business, you know, so long, because the quantity you normally, you know, order for, that will be reduced due to the high tariff, you know, on the product.
The government is convinced that this move will not only increase revenue, but also reduce hazards from diseases related to excessive consumption. The new tariff rates are in line with the West African Regional Body's directive on the harmonizing member states' legislation in excise duties.
Government is raising taxes, but government have to be more careful in putting taxes in this industry because they have multiplier effects. It's not only consumer within the same economy that are consuming the product, and government is getting revenue from the same tobacco, because a tobacco that is produced by the then Nigerian Tobacco Company, now British Tobacco, is consumed locally and internationally. So tobacco is also playing a significant role in government revenue, both in taxes and in excise duties.
As it stands, Nigeria remains one of the countries with the lowest tariffs in Africa at 23.2%, against Ghana's 28.3%, Gambia's 30%, South Africa's 36.5%, and Algeria's 38.4%. The new rates will see consumers pay more for the affected products, although the government says it will be spread over the next 3 years. The tariff hike takes effect from the 4th of June, but the National Union of Food, Beverages and Tobacco Employees are strongly fighting against it. They fear that more than 20,000 workers are at risk of losing their jobs as a result of the hike. Terry Wangari for CGTN.